IPMI was originally created in late 90s by Intel as a way to remotely access and manage servers. IT or professionals or experts about that specific server, the ability to access it from anywhere in the world. So it gives large companies like Dell, Cisco, Intel, companies like that, the ability to put servers anywhere and then have their experts located together in one place or anywhere in the world. With IPMI, you can connect to it and manage it at any level as long as there's an internet connection between the two devices that you're connecting. So traditionally, when you're connecting to a machine remotely, you're normally just working at it or working with it on an OS level. So if you remotely connect using Windows's tool, you can control it as if you were in front of the computer, but only at the OS level. IPMI gives you a further capability with things like being able to connect a USB drive and remotely install any software or anything that you need to install, but it also gives you the ability to control it from a BIOS level, which isn't, you're not able to do that from any OS level tool. And then you can also control the power of the system, so you can actually turn the system on and off. You could have a system sit for weeks at a time and then power it on for any maintenance. So traditionally, whenever you're using it in a server setting, there's always power and internet available to the servers, and they're kind of, the infrastructure's there. But whenever you're moving to embedded systems, and embedded systems can be anywhere, they can be, you know, in space and in wind turbines or in the middle of a field somewhere. As long as you have a power and an internet connection, you can control IPMI and use it to its fullest ability anywhere. So far, IPMI has been used to satisfy the needs of one of our largest military customers, and with our experience from that, we're gonna be able to roll that into any custom product or any standard product that we choose to in the future. From a security standpoint, I definitely think it changes the way that we think about design, because introducing the access of anywhere in the world, it definitely gives the thought of who's going to have access to this computer. You know, ideally it would always be the right person, but everybody knows in the world that sometimes the right person doesn't have access, or sometimes the wrong person gets access. And so from a hardware perspective, we need to make sure that we implement security features that both prevent the wrong people from getting access, but also allow the right people to get access. Redfish is the next generation of IPMI. It gives you all the capabilities and functions of IPMI with more security and a lower memory profile. As we move forward, our future designs will incorporate more of Redfish, and we'll continue to use IPMI, but Redfish is what we're looking forward to using in the future. One of the things that excites me the most about IPMI is just its ability to be used anywhere. It doesn't have to be used, you know, locally here on the planet. It can be used anywhere in as far as space. You know, we could send satellites as far as we can send them physically and still be able to connect to them as long as there's an internet connection between us. And that gives us the ability to monitor them, record data, provide maintenance to them.